When I say Gainax, what comes to your mind? For me, three things. This. This man was Tomohiro Maki, and he's got arrested for indecent acts. And that guy was the president of Gainax. To me, Gainax was dead since a long time, and it didn't get the end it deserved. Gainax, the studio who gave birth to Evangelion, Gurren Lagann, and Furikuri, yet Gainax disappeared without realizing it. So who Gainax actually died? The story of Gainax began in 1978 with an Osaka University freshman called Toshio Okada. And since the beginning of the year, he skipped classes to stay in the science fiction club room. But for Okada, it wasn't just to kill the time. In fact, he had a very deep passion for science fiction. He wanted to explore this area, discuss with other people, and why not produce something around it? And luckily for him, he's gonna have the opportunity to do so. In 1981, the third edition of an anime convention called Daicon was about to head in Osaka. Unsurprisingly, he joined the organization staff and planned to do the opening of the con. One key moment of the Daicon is the anime short movie screened to open the con, a project Okada will direct with three other freshmen, Hideaki Anno, Hiroyuki Yamaga, and Tamaki Akai. And as you can expect from students leading their first project, it was a mess. They were passionate, but none of them did animation before, so they had to learn how to do it right in a bat. Yet they finished the project at the very morning of the Daicon, and despite all the difficulties, Okada and the others had a great time making the film, so they will continue to make anime, but they will follow a different path. Anno, Yamaga and Akai will work on anime project, especially in Macross, while Okada will create his own company, General Products, with his friend Takeshi Sawamura, to get a fund for animation materials. With all this experience and money, they came back all together to animate the Daicon 4 opening. And it will be a massive success, up to the point it will become the most memorable anime short film in the 80s. After this success, the four men had to make a choice, pursue their studies or their love for animation. But since all of them already dropped out, the decision was quick to make. In 1984, they will found their own anime studio, called Gainax. Running a company when you're still in your 20s is not easy, and for Omets it will be the source of many issues in their first production, the Wink of Honneamise. Thanks to the success of General Products, Gainax had the privilege to collaborate with Bandai, and with the influence of Bandai, Gainax could reach two big figures in the industry, Mamoru Oshii and Hayao Miyazaki. Okada pitched them Honneamise, and both of them were excited about it. And since they approved the project, Gainax greenlit it for production. And this production was chaotic. Because of the ambition of the team, despite the lack of experience, the movie was well directed and it will receive a good reception. But Honneamise won't refund the production cost, which was about $3 million. Despite this failure, Gainax could count on several deals to compensate the losses. General Products, the partnership with Bandai and the in-house game created by Akai. With these earnings, Gainax could continue to release animes, Gunbusters in 1998 and Nadia the next year. Nadia's production was chaotic and made a loss of $500,000. The employees asked for better management, which Okada didn't do, so people wanted Okada to leave. And after an ultimate dispute with Akai, Toshio Okada will leave Gainax in 1992, and his friend Takeshi Sawamura will replace him as president. The new president Sawamura faced hard time after Okada's departure. General Products ran out of business and their partnership with Bandai ended. Besides the game earnings, Gainax hadn't any source of money, so they couldn't produce anime, so they couldn't earn money. In front of this crisis, several employees including Tamaki Akai will leave the boat, and the remaining one had a pay cut, if they were paid at all. No money, no employees, no animes, Gainax was on the verge of bankruptcy. But one man will come to the rescue. In 1995, Anno received the opportunity to launch a brand new anime project by the music label King Records, a surprising event for Gainax, and Sawamura knew it will be his last chance to save the studio. So he begged Anno to produce his project in Gainax. And Anno agreed. Gainax then worked in their first anime since Nadia, but the lack of money was still here. Gainax got only 3 employees, not enough to produce a TV show. So most of the production was handled by the larger studio, Tatsunoko, which also managed the production. Plus, there were barely enough funds to produce it. If this project failed, Gainax would have been done. And after 1 year of production, the first episode of Neon Genesis Evangelion aired. And the anime became the most successful anime franchise of all time. The anime topped VHS sales ranking and it became a cultural phenomenon. Eva didn't only save Gainax from bankruptcy, but flooded the company in money, and for President Sawamura, the success was personal. Eva had to be a success, and it became one. After all the sacrifices he had to make, Gainax would finally be back on tracks. But unfortunately for him, he will be arrested for tax fraud in 1999. Yamaga will replace him as president. Despite that, and thanks to the earnings of Evangelion, Gainax started to produce many projects. And I think you guessed what happened. None of them were a success and the studio was on the verge of bankruptcy. And once again, Hideaki Anno came to the rescue with Evangelion. Or to be more accurate, the Evangelion pachinko slot machines were so successful that Gainax got back on tracks. And once again, they released new projects, none of them were successful, and Gainax was on the verge of bankruptcy again. And once again, Hideaki Anno came to the rescue with Evangelion. In 2006, Anno planned to direct a new EVA trilogy, the reboot of Evangelion, but he didn't want to make in Gainax for two reasons. First, he wanted to keep the control of every aspect of the production. And second, he didn't want to bother the youngsters working on Gurren Lagann at this period. So he left Gainax to establish his own studio. But before leaving, Anno made a deal with his former company. Since Gara was a small company, Anno wanted to focus on EVA's filming, so he let the management of the EVA rights to Gainax. Thanks to this gift, Gainax would survive a little bit more, and released Gurren Lagann in 2007 and Plenty and Stalking in 2010. And this time there will be two major successes, and Gainax was back in business almost by their own. But the staff of these animes will leave and establish their own studio, Trigger in 2011. And this time Gainax lost his last generation of talented animators. Some anime will be released like Dentai Line no Shoka or Hokage no Pleiades, but nothing as great as Gurren Lagann. Once again, the studio was on the verge of bankruptcy. And for the fourth time, Anno was here to the rescue. In 2014, and in the name of his long friendship, he gave a loan of almost $1 million to Gainax. And unfortunately for him, he will never see this money again. And worse, he will discover that the studio sold the rights of former works, especially Gunbusters and Furikuri. Anno, who worked on these shows, wasn't consulted at all. Plus, Gainax established multiple subsidiaries across Japan. After discovering that, Anno sued Gainax for not paying the loan, but at this day he never received any explanation or apology from Gainax or Yamaga, who will finally leave the company in October 2019. Tomohiro Maki, president of Gainax International, has been chosen to replace him, but as you know, he will be arrested 2 months later for sexual harassment, and this will be the final picture of Gainax most people will have. Yet Gainax still exists, with new representatives and new project. But it's already clear for most of us, Gainax already died for a long time. The story of Gainax illustrates an important lesson you should remember if you want to run a company someday. Great talent doesn't compensate poor management. Sure, Okada, Anno and the others were incredibly talented, and they will be forever remembered for what they did to the industry. But their lack of business skill didn't avoid them repeating the same mistakes over and over again. Messy production, no budgeting plans, no long-term vision. Each time, Gainax was saved by more writers' company, or business voice people. Yes, learning the basics of finance, management and law is awfully boring. You don't understand anything and the only thing you want to do is creating. But you need to do this. And better, the talent needs you to do this. It will force you to focus on your goal on the long term. So let me comment your result, and if you wanna know where it can lead you, you can follow this example, which is not available yet when I release this video. So subscribe to the channel to not miss it. And don't forget, anime is an art, but also a business. A la prochaine, les filles.